Hey everyone, welcome back to our channel. If you're new here, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the bell icon so you won't miss our future videos. Today, we're taking a unique approach to interview preparation by delving into the world of user engagement analytics on Canva's platform. You might be wondering, what does Canva have to do with interviews? Well, stick around, and you'll find out. Whether you're preparing for a technical interview or aiming to stand out in a competitive job market, analyzing real-world datasets like the one from Canva's platform can be an invaluable exercise. It's all about honing your skills and showcasing your potential as a top-tier candidate. And, please note that the example questions and assumption tables presented in this video should not be taken as representative of the real interview or actual source tables that will be encountered in real-world applications. SQL query construction involves more than simply selecting the right table. It requires careful consideration of existing data schema analysis and their actual column mapping relationship analysis tasks. Although we cannot discuss every possible scenario in this video, I hope this overview provides a helpful starting point. Now, let's get started. Write a T-SQL query to find out the total number of users who signed up on Canva each month for the past year. We're interested in understanding the monthly sign-up trends on Canva's platform over the past year. This requires extracting the sign-up date from the user data and grouping it by month. Let's suppose we have a table named User Sign-up Data containing information about user sign-ups. You can write a SQL query as follows. This SQL query extracts the year and month from the signup date column using the format function, and then counts the number of signups for each month. It groups the results by month and orders them chronologically. To answer this question, I first needed to extract the month and year from the signup dates. I utilized the format function to achieve this. Then, I counted the number of signups for each month using the count function and grouped the results by month. Finally, I ordered the results by month to present them chronologically. Even if your query is technically correct, explain your thought process and reasoning clearly. Show the interviewer you understand the logic behind your approach. Don't be afraid to ask clarifying questions if you're unsure about the data or the desired outcome. Let's move on to the next question. Write a SQL query to identify the top three most downloaded design templates on Canva in terms of the number of downloads. We want to determine the top performing design templates on Canva's platform based on the number of downloads. This requires analyzing the download data and selecting the templates with the highest download counts. We have a table named Design Downloads containing information about templates and their downloads quantity. Here is the SQL query for this question. This SQL query selects the top three design templates based on the number of downloads from the Design Downloads table. It orders the templates in descending order of downloads using the order by clause and limits the result to the top three using the top keyword. To address this question, I first recognize the need to rank the design templates based on download counts. I utilize the order by clause to sort the templates in descending order of downloads. Then, I use the top keyword to select only the top three templates with the highest download counts, effectively identifying the top performing templates on Canva's platform. Let's proceed with another question. Write a SQL query to calculate the average session duration of users on Canva's platform, excluding sessions shorter than 1 minute. We aim to determine the average duration of user sessions on Canva, filtering out sessions that lasted less than 1 minute. This analysis provides insight into user engagement on the platform. Now, let's write the SQL query for this question. Please feel free to pause the video and try solving the query yourself. When finished, resume the video. Repeat this for each question. This SQL query calculates the average session duration for users on Canva's platform, excluding sessions with a duration shorter than 1 minute. It filters out such sessions using the WHERE clause and then computes the average duration using the AVG function. To address this question, I recognize the need to filter out sessions shorter than 1 minute to focus on meaningful user engagements. I applied a WHERE clause to exclude these sessions from the calculation. Then, I used the AVG function to find the average session duration, providing valuable insights into user behavior on Canva's platform. Let's proceed with another question. Write a SQL query to find the total number of premium users who have created at least 5 designs on Canva's platform. We want to identify premium users who are actively engaged on Canva by creating a significant number of designs. This requires querying data from 2 tables, one for user subscription status and another for design creation count. Here is the SQL query for this question. This SQL query utilizes an inner join between the user subscription and design creation tables on the user ID column to match premium users with their design creation counts. It then filters the results to include only premium users who have created at least 5 designs and counts the distinct premium users meeting this criteria. To solve this question, I recognize the need to combine information from both the user subscription and design creation tables. I used an inner join to match premium users from the user subscription table with their corresponding design creation counts from the design creation table, based on the user ID. Then, I applied filters to select only premium users with at least 5 design creations, ensuring accurate identification of actively engaged premium users on Canva's platform. Let's explore another question. Write a SQL query to calculate the total revenue generated from premium users who have purchased Canva's subscription within the last month. We want to analyze the revenue generated from premium subscriptions within a specific time frame. This requires querying data from 2 tables, one for user subscription details and another for subscription purchase history. Here is the SQL query for this question. This SQL query joins the user subscription details and subscription purchase history tables on the user ID and filters the results to include only premium users who made purchases within the last month. It then calculates the total revenue generated by summing the purchase amounts. To address this question, I recognize the need to combine data from both the user subscription details and subscription purchase history tables. I used an inner join to match premium users from the user subscription details table with their purchase history from the subscription purchase history table based on the user ID. Then, I applied filters to select only premium users who made purchases within the last month and calculated the total revenue by summing the purchase amounts. This provides insight into the revenue generated from premium subscriptions within the specified time frame. Let's proceed with another question. Write a SQL query to find the average rating given by users to each category of designs on Canva's platform. We want to analyze the average rating given by users to different categories of designs. This requires querying data from 2 tables, one for design categories and another for user ratings. Here is the SQL query for this question. Please feel free to pause the video and try solving the query yourself. When finished, resume the video. Repeat this for each question. This SQL query joins the design categories and user design ratings tables on the design ID and calculates the average rating for each design category. It groups the results by category using the group by clause and computes the average rating using the AVG function. To solve this question, I recognize the need to combine data from both the design categories and user ratings tables. I used an inner join to match design categories from the design categories table with their corresponding ratings from the user design ratings table based on the design ID. Then, I calculated the average rating for each category by grouping the results by category and using the AVG function. This provides valuable insights into user satisfaction with different categories of designs on Canva's platform. Let's proceed with another question. Write a SQL query to find the top 5 most active countries in terms of user engagement on Canva's platform, based on the total number of designs created by users from each country. We aim to identify the countries with the highest user engagement on Canva by analyzing the total number of designs created by users from each country. This requires querying data from a user table that includes country information and a design creation table. Here is the SQL query for this question. This SQL query joins the user activity and design creation tables on the user ID and calculates the total number of designs created by users from each country. It then orders the results by the total number of designs in descending order and limits the output to the top 5 countries with the highest user engagement. To address this question, I recognize the need to combine data from both the user activity and design creation tables. I used an inner join to match user countries from the user activity table with their corresponding design creation records from the design creation table based on the user ID. Then, I calculated the total number of designs created by users from each country and ordered the results to identify the top 5 countries with the highest user engagement on Canva's platform. This analysis provides valuable insights into global user activity on the platform. Let's proceed with another question. Write a SQL query to identify users who have both downloaded design templates and created designs on Canva's platform. We want to find users who are actively engaged on Canva's platform by both downloading design templates and creating designs. This requires querying data from 2 different tables, one for design downloads and another for design creation. Here is the SQL query for this question. This SQL query joins the design downloads and design creation tables on the user ID and selects distinct user IDs who have both downloaded design templates and created designs on Canva's platform. To solve this question, I recognize the need to identify users who have performed both download and creation activities on Canva's platform. I used an inner join to match user IDs from the design downloads and design creation tables based on the user ID. Then, I selected distinct user IDs to ensure each user appears only once in the result set, indicating users who have engaged in both activities. This analysis provides insight into the overlap between design download and creation behaviors among Canva users. Let's proceed with another question. Write a SQL query to calculate the total number of likes received by each user on Canva's platform for the designs they have created. We want to analyze user engagement on Canva's platform by calculating the total number of likes received by users for their created designs. This requires querying data from a table that records user IDs and the corresponding number of likes for each design. Here is the SQL query for this question. This SQL query groups the data in the user design likes table by user ID and calculates the sum of likes received for each user's designs. It provides the total number of likes received by each user on Canva's platform. To solve this question, I recognize the need to aggregate the likes received by users for their designs. I use the sum function to calculate the total number of likes for each user by grouping the data based on the user ID. This query provides insights into user engagement on Canva's platform by quantifying the popularity of users' designs through the total number of likes received. And that's it for today's video. I hope this helps you in your preparation for your SQL interview. Remember, practice makes perfect. So, keep practicing these concepts and queries. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Don't forget to leave your comments below. Until next time, keep learning and stay curious.